This short video will demonstrate how to host and utilize an entire virtual studio in the cloud using Qumulo. All of the activity in this demo takes place within the AWS ecosystem. All compute and storage is cloud-based. Remote access is provided by Teradici remote control software and viewed with a software client. We begin by looking at a Qumulo storage cluster that is hosted in AWS. Qumulo provides multi-protocol support for SMB, NFS, FTP, and REST in the cloud. Our first demonstration is of Maya running on a Linux AWS GPU instance. You will see that a small project file hosted on the AWS Qumulo cluster is opened over an NFS mount. Note the Maya GUI responsiveness. With reasonable internet connectivity and low latency, Maya functions the same in AWS as if it was running locally. Next, we render a single frame using V-Ray. Any programs and renders can be run natively in the cloud. We take our project file and in Blender, we can view a short animation. Again, note the responsiveness of the GUI and the smooth animation playback. All of this is running in AWS. Nothing is running locally. We save our animation to a new version and switch over to ThinkBox Deadline. This is a queue manager also running completely in AWS, backed by Qumulo Storage. We submit a Blender job to Deadline and begin filling in the usual fields, such as job name. Next, we select which file to render. Note the file browser that opens. No object translation is needed, as all the project assets are stored as files. We browse until we find our file to render and select it. Finally, we define the output file names for the completed render frames. We hit submit and wait until Deadline confirms successful submission to the queue. We close these windows and browse the submitted jobs, scrolling up to our new job. Clicking on it, we can see that the first few frames are being distributed to our render farm. In this demo, there are 13 Linux instances within AWS that have been spun up as a small render farm to generate our animation. If we jump back to the browser, we can see that there is now some activity on our Qumulo cluster. Real-time activity is represented in the IOPS and throughput graphs present on the main page. We can zoom in and see the activity in detail. Clicking on Qumulo's real-time analytics section and selecting throughput hotspots, we can see that the activity is primarily the source render file being accessed while write throughput is occurring in the directory complete. Next, we look at activity by client, and we can see the individual render nodes and the throughput and IOPS generated by each client. Clicking on an IP address shows the actual files being accessed. In this case, we see the source file being read and individual frames being written out. If we go to activity by path, we can see the same activity, but you can see that it is designated by path. Again, the render source file dominates the reads. Completed frames are written to the complete directory, and we can watch them write out in real time. If we click on a path, we can see the individual clients that are accessing the selected file. Next, we jump back to Deadline to check on the progress of our render. There are 100 frames in total to be rendered, and the animation is nearly complete. Once finished, we can view our animation. We open DJV View to load all the frames and watch the complete animation. Note the file selection window. We are still working with files and still completely within AWS. We navigate to the complete directory and select our fully rendered animation. Playback occurs at a smooth 24 frames per second. We can also jog back and forth within the animation if there is some part that is particularly of interest. Now that we have a completed animation, let's add it to a video editorial project. We open DaVinci Resolve and see our editorial timeline. Like the other programs that we have been using, performance is high enough that we can jog back and forth along the timeline. Playback of multiple streams is fast enough that even transitions can be viewed in real time. Let's move to the end of the timeline and add our newly completed animation. We use Resolve's file browser, navigate to the NFS mounted directory where our render is, select the frames, and import it into a bin. Next, we drag our animation from a bin into the timeline, position it appropriately, and add a quick fade transition. If we jog back a bit in the timeline and hit play, we can view the end of the Qumulo demo segment, a previous render, and then finally our new render. We can also jump back to the Qumulo GUI and see the file activity by Resolve in real time. You have just watched a complete virtual studio in action. CGI assets were created, animation was rendered and edited completely in the cloud, using Qumulo as the file storage system supporting it all.